Okay, class. Good morning. So we shall begin now. So what topic are we going to discuss today? Rule number 10.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Do you know what topic we do since last one day back?
Anti-diarrheal agent.
Okay. Have you got any idea? Any one or two information what you gained through last session? Just tell me what you learned. In last class, that lecture, I think you learned something new or anything new that you didn't know before. What can you share what you learned,
ma'am? About the principle of oral rehydration solution. ORS should be isotonic or hypotonic, and molar ratio of glucose should be higher or equal to equal or higher than the sodium, and enough potassium and bicarbonate should be provided to make up the uses in the stool.
Okay, don't laugh. Just say what you know. If you don't know, it's okay. That is the main thing. Okay, and to come up to today's content of this oral rehydration solution, a lot of time has been given, so it is very important to know its content. Okay, and the most important modality in treating the diarrhea is giving intravenous fluid or this ORS. So we need to make the patient first stable, alive, then proceed to further treatment. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, what's your name? So we were talking about this mild, moderate, and severe fluid loss. For this, you don't need to know in detail in pharmacology. In subsequent internal medicine or in pediatrics, you will know to calculate how this is calculated. Okay, through the appearance, if the patient is lethargic or active or unconscious, through the pulse rate or through the tongue dryness or fontanel, assessing all this, we come to this mild, moderate, and severe fluid loss. Okay, so for now you only know what we do in mild, moderate fluid loss and how we treat in adult and children. Okay, I'll give you slides to the to your CR, and he or she will distribute to you all. So how to administer ORS. Roshan, do you know the full form of ORS? In solution. Okay. So, if the fluid loss is mild to moderate, then orally we can give this ORS. Okay. For adult, 2 to 3 liters of ORS would be consumed within first 4 hours. Therefore, as much he passes the stool, that amount of ORS should be ingested. Then that would be enough. But in children, it should be given quite slowly. That would be 5 ml per kg per hour, and we should aim to restore the hydration within 6 hours. Okay, so later on, when patient becomes stable, then we can give such ORS on demand whenever they feel thirsty or they want to drink fluid. This is the modality of giving ORS. So other than diarrhea, this ORS can be given in various conditions, like after surgery, there is a rapid fluid loss in burn cases, post-burn, post-trauma, like severe accident. So in such situation, this ORS, if the patient is able to swallow or eat through oral via their mouth, then in that condition also ORS can be given. And heat stroke and during the change of, okay, rule number 15. Hello. Roll number 20. Roll number 18. Are you there?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Roll number 20. Do you know anything about heat stroke? We give ORS in cases abnormal condition, like heat stroke also. Okay, do you have any idea?
due to excessive heat, the patient is unconscious or has lost a huge amount of fluid in the body.
It's an illness resulting in headache, like you said, confusion. Okay, it results when there is temperature greater than 104 degree centigrade. Okay, so in such situation also this ORS is useful. Okay, thank you. Okay, so welcome. And then the other third point where ORS is used is you know after surgery the patient are kept nil per orally. Okay, they can't eat anything after surgery to avoid the side effects of anesthetic agent. We keep patient nil per oral. That means we don't give anything for upcoming 24 hours to such patient. And later we need to start giving food and liquid to the patient so as to bring him or her back to the normal eating habit. So in such situation, First, we don't give solid food directly, okay? We give liquid, semi-solid, and solid diet. So, beginning from intravenous, in the form of liquid diet, first we can give either black tea or we can give such ORS also, okay? When we want to shift the patient from nil per orally to oral route or to from intravenous to oral route, we can give start their nutrition through such liquid diet, black tea or such kind of ORS. During changeover from intravenous to enteral alimentation, this means that when patient are giving only this is another condition also, when patient are given intravenous fluid, intravenous medication, and when such duration of oral intravenous route is enough and we need to shift to oral route of such medication, then we can also give ORS and start such oral route of giving such food or such this liquid diet. Okay, so how we give anti-diarrheal agents in intravenous hydration fluid and what is the name of this fluid, you need to know. Okay, and when we give this intravenous hydration, rule number 15, you there? Rule number 28. Okay, Roshan. When we give intravenous rehydration therapy other than ORS, ORS is orally, right? Give it.
And when the patient is unconscious or in coma.
Okay, when he or she can't eat. Okay, good. And then? And then fluid loss is more than 10% of body weight. Okay, good. Okay, this you need to understand. Okay, and this how to calculate this body weight loss 10%, 7%, you don't need to worry in pharmacology. In other subsequent department, you will be taught. It's very detailed. It's a long process, like assessing pulse, your fontanel, sunken or not. There are lots of criteria, like 10 or 15 criteria you will know later. For now, just know mild, moderate, and severe kind of fluid loss only. Okay, so for intravenous rehydration we use IV fluid, or we call it Dhaka fluid also, because its discovery was potentially discovered in Dhaka, so it has got named Dhaka fluid also. So here the concentration of NaCl is 85 mm, KCl 13 millimole, sodium bicarbonate 48 millimole. Okay, we give such solute mixture in 1 liter of water or 5% of glucose solution. So how we give intravenous therapy it is not same as in case of children and adult. Okay, children we need to give children quite slowly rather than in adult. Okay, rule number 50, rule number 29, Monica. Monica, are you there?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Do you have any idea why we give this such intravenous rehydrating fluid quite slowly in children than in adults? We should give it quite slowly. See here. Even 5 hours in children, but it is given slowly in adult. We need to give it slowly. Just tell me basic principle if you know. If you don't know, say okay. If you say yes, then you can share with us.
Maybe it can cause some adverse effect to children's if given fast food.
Mm-hmm. And what that adverse effect would be? You're right.
Diarrhea, vomiting.
Not actually. Okay, listen. If we give such intravenous, then there will be the swelling of the abdomen in children. Okay, and there will be fluid overload to the heart of children. Okay, so in children we give such fluid at the rate of 30 ml per kg in 1 hour. Then after 1 hour, that amount is increased to 70 ml per kg. And this 70 ml per kg is given within 5 hours time period. Okay. And in adult, it is same 30 ml per kg, but duration is quite fast. And after 30 minutes, we give same 70 ml per kg, but that is also quite faster. We should finish this amount of fluid within two and a half hour time period, okay? Then patient becomes stable, then we can proceed to further treatment. So, as in our concept, in our, as tradition in our society, that we are afraid to give solid food to the patient suffering from diarrhea. But this is not good because fasting, During the fasting, this disaccharidase enzyme is destroyed, okay? And this reduces the absorption of salt and water electrolyte, and this may lead to malnutrition if diarrhea is prolonged or recurrent, okay? So fasting is decreasing this enzyme, which is very useful in absorbing such fluid and water electrolytes. So in order to preserve this, food should be given quite frequently, so as to maintain nourishment in such diarrhea, patients having diarrhea. So drug therapy, there are different modalities, non-specific antidiarrheal drugs and antimicrobial drugs is also there, probiotics and specific, and connection had gone disconnected. Are you there? There was problem in internet again. So we will be proceeding to the therapy of to treat the diarrhea. Okay, so non-specific, here comes opioid derivatives, and I don't know how to use it. Return to meeting. Just wait. Okay, screen your slide. Dekhinare. Okay, lots of disturbances, but we need to go on. We have such. And anticholinergics, alpha 2 agonist, okay, opioid derivatives, lots of stuffs are there. So let's begin. So you guys know about opioids. Have you heard of it previously? Roll number 85.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. How many receptors are there in opioids?
I don't know.
Okay, there are alpha, delta, and kappa. Okay. And these drugs, they act at mu and delta receptors. This loperamide, diphenoxylate, resicadotril, diphenoxin, okay? It's active metabolite of diphenoxylate. And mode of action is same of this diphenoxin and diphenoxylate. And its dose is also approximately same. But this is, these all act in mu and delta receptors. Anticholinergics, any idea? ANS, you have read it. They decrease the secretion of GI tract, salivary gland, and other organs also, okay? And alpha 2 adrenergic receptor agonist like clonidine, okay? So we will learn it in detail later. So clonidine, it increases or decreases the secretion of adrenaline. Any idea? Roll number 51. 51?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Do you know what clonidine does in the secretion of norepinephrine? It increases or decreases?
It increases.
Mm-hmm. alpha 2 adrenergic agonists, they decrease. Okay, we will talk in detail later. Then you need to revise your ANS also. Okay, so octreotide, this is synthetic analog of somatostatin. Okay, thank you, 51. Okay, let's proceed. So, mechanism of action, how these opioid agonists act? By acting on mu receptors, it decreases the
Rupesh Kumar is the host now.
My screen froze a bit.
Janak.
Motu.
Delta receptor clicking or someone. Host. Oh, Mono Zansi.
Yes.
Mono.
Roll
number 56.
ओ 55 आयो
हजुर हजुर
म त रोल नम्बर हटाउँछ यार
मैम सुदीप के
भइरहेको
त्यो थका रह्यो यार
मैम आइ सक्छु
हेलो प्लीज हां
जानु
के छ नाम आयो
आवाज
Roll number 56.
Sustrika is a host. Padao Sustrika.
Delta.
New Delta.
For the host, why?
Head of the potential, they hear it in the host.
मिन्छ
समीर मनोज हो
जनक
उदेश घरे लैले भने ल
गाय गाय गाय
सुदीप दाई सुन्नै पाउनु भएन कि त्यतिखेर सुदीप दाई यस्तो रमाइलो भएको थियो
अब सुनौ नि त ल
सुना जनक सुनाइदे जनक त्यही भने आमा म जनकको हेर त सानहरू सुपरस्टार
आज पढ्ने होइन सक्यो
सक्यो सुदीप दाइ
मलाई अनि म यहाँ होइन के
म यहाँ
रिसेप्टर चाहिँ कुन हुन्छ मलाई भन त मैले दिनै नसुने नाम सुन्नु
पाइहाल्यो
यहाँ रेकर्ड हुन सक्छ
सुस्तिका भन् त ओपनमा कुन रिसिभर हुन्छ
हुँदैन र
ल बाई गाइस
काका
Yes, yes, yes. Bye-bye.